Well, my Uncle Julius was the first of three boys, born in 1916. My dad said he was kind of, today you would call him a hothead, but if he was a friend of yours, he's okay. So he probably didn't get along with everybody and just wanted to get out on his own as soon as he could. So he just peddled it out to California and got a job driving truck. It was right at 1939, and at that time, everybody that was a male of younger age, single, were joining military, and because that's what you did. Well, he decided to join at the same time his friend, Robert Dork, joined, and they joined the California 41st Infantry, which California Guard Unit. They then got their orders for training in Fort Lewis, Washington. And they arrived there and found out that Brainerd's 194th Tank Battalion was also there. And they said, I want to be with my hometown buddies. And his friend Robert said, I'll go with you. So the two of them joined and off they went. And that was the beginning of their travels to the Philippines. Well, the April 9th is when the surrender happened. So then all the guys were told to, the tankers were told to shoot rounds into their own tanks or their neighboring tank to destroy it so it couldn't be used against them. And all the trucks and jeeps, everybody was told to rip up the radiator caps and distributor caps and make them not usable so they can't be used against you and destroy all ammunition. So now they're totally defenseless. So they had to surrender or get annihilated. So at that point, they all were herded by Japanese forces into that main trail along the Bataan Peninsula going north to where the prisoner of war camps were. But it took 60 miles. That's like going from here to St. Cloud, walking. Most of them are very unhealthy, dysentery, mosquitoes, all the diseases you can imagine from being no medical help, no food, no water, and they're drinking out of pools of water on the side of the road that are full of not good things. And some of the stuff they went through on that death march is just unbelievable. And you think about that, you know, how could people do that to somebody? So that march was not good. Just thinking about it, you know, just God, what those guys went through, just terrible. And then my uncle, no one knows for sure, but Colonel Miller noted in his hand notes that were kept in a POW camp underneath their building in a can hidden from the Japanese, and he made notes constantly. And they found that after the war and transcribed most of it. And his notes said that my Uncle Julius was last seen near the town of Labau. And right under that, it says last seen Robert Dork, diddle marks, near the town of Labau. So that's our first major breakthrough in information of where my uncle was last seen. If they found my uncle and they're going to bring him home, there'll be a hearse on the highway with people on the overpasses with flags. I can just envision what would happen.